Demers up to center, will swing it back. Here comes Barkov. Taves watches him. The drop for Huberto. He's in. Sets up Barkov with a chance. He scores! Alexander Barkov, beautiful!
Great pass by Huberto, which we've gotten used to. And I'm telling you what, that was a beauty of a shot. He just got flat out beat by a great wrist.
Marchessault again, right on the doorstep. It's Barkov firing high over the net. Now it's Yandle. Barkov again. Chalmerson is there. Huberto shoots and scores! Hoobie-dooby-doo! 2-0 Florida!
Crawford wasn't far away. That was just a little bit of very good passing and not a lot of hesitation.
Yandle. Barkov. Sets up Huberto. He'll wait. He'll give to Barkov. Cross-ice feed score! It's Marchessault!
Florida Panthers have shown a pretty good hockey team in the NHL how to run a power play. And again, who makes a better pass than Barkov?
Looks like they're switching out those right wingers with Barkov and Huberto. With Jágr not in there, here comes Sevier with Marchessault. 2-on-1, Marchessault scores again!
He does not hesitate. If there's ever a guy that is an automatic trigger right now, it's got to be Jonathan Marchessault. Coming season.
Sign for next year.
Yeah.
Here comes Huberto. It's a 3-on-2. Marchessault is on the near wing. Gets the feed. In front for Huberto. Back to Marchessault. Darling makes the save.
Is it in? It is in the
net. It's a goal. It's a hat trick. Jonathan Marchessault. The first hat trick for a Panther at home in 4 years. Forget 27. It's 28.
I mean, who had 5 goals in 2 games for the Panthers? That never happened.
Penalty on the Blackhawks. Delayed call. Sevier scores! And it may have been deflected in by Bjugstad in front. Up 6-0, trying to win their second straight game. Last 2 games here at home, they've outscored the opposition 9-1. Trocheck with a look. Save, rebound, Riley Smith! Touchdown, Panthers! 7-0.
Smith follows up, looking for Sissons in the slot. Wilson got it to Sissons and scores! Sissons is in a dangerous spot. The alert play of Wilson to get it into Sissons, and Sissons in back-to-back contest.
Ellis stands up yet another play at that blue line. When is somebody going to learn? What a move! Here's Yossi! He hit the crossbar, rebound, score! Cody McLeod!
Rink wide, Yossi is open, and he sends it. Yossi, the important strike, the clean entry. McLeod follows up.
Sharks go to work. Very dangerous group. Here's Thornton. Right up the middle, Burns. Back of the net. Tipped in. Patrick Marleau from the circle.
Working around the top and then right back to Burns. Burns quick to get it back towards the net. Says it ricochets in behind Pecorine.
So a chance to answer with a power play. Thornton goes to work. Off the set play. All of it's a down low to Neal. Neal scores!
Neal is actually into the skate of James Neal. He pops it back up right there. And then quick release, snapper neutralizing Brett Burns, 88 for the Sharks.
Now shot Neal, right into the traffic. Burns engaged, the shot, Subban scores!
Middle is using their coach's challenge on goaltender interference.
Did Jones have the ability to reset, to recalibrate and front that shot again? I would say yes, he did.
There was no goaltender interference, we have a goal.
Danilo finds the man. Shot from Braun. Renate looking to cut him. Pulls it off and they score.
Braun throws it down and again follows up off the rebound.
Puck still loose, sent just wide. Jones couldn't find it. Wilson to the slot, Smith, score! Sissons was in front!
Colton Sissons on the backhand. Right here, this will show you. Catches a little piece of that.
Yossi to the middle. Back to Johansson. Down low, Neal turns, slam dunks it. James Neal, his second of the night. Both on the power play.
They can't recover in time. It's just Neal and Jones, and Neal gets the better of Jones' job.
Sometimes
not only making that initial shot, Willie. Notice he has steered it out of traffic.
Here comes Arvidsson, swooping in. He scores.
Makes it a 7-2 game.
Sekiro will give it to Eberle. Jordan Eberle. Cross ice pass, Maroon scores! Patrick Maroon! It's 1-0 for Edmonton.
Draws two men to him, And that opened up the passing lane, and Patrick Maroon makes no mistake.
Spinning. Up the middle, finds Dreisaitl, moving in with McDavid. McDavid knocks it down, centering pass, Maroon has done it again! Patrick Maroon, his second goal, it's 2-0!
Knock it down, tip it over, and Patrick Maroon doing what he does best.
He's trying to take advantage of it. Desharnais, Nurse jumping up. Desharnais circles the net, still has it, lets it go in front, deflected in!
Benoit Pouliot stays onside. He slides a little bit to the middle, and now he commits to being in the tough areas.
Marchand behind the net, Bergeron out in front, cleared by Nugent Hopkins, only to the line as Krug was there to keep it in. Spooner down low. Here's Pasternak again, and this time he puts it in.
The angle of attack has changed not once but twice, and a beautiful finish by David Pasternak gets goal number 31.
Now Chera will jump on it. Zdeno Chera circles the net. Chera out in front, side of the net, Marchand scores! Brad Marchand, his 37th goal of the season.
Everybody's looking at Zdeno Chera. Nobody picks Marchand up, coming off the bench, who does smart thing, disappears.
On the right side with McDavid. Nurse cutting for the net, one-handed shot. McDavid trying to bank it in. Slepyshev does! Anton Slepyshev! It's 4-2.
Going back to what Louis DeBrus talked about last game, the confidence of Darnell. McDavid throws it right on net, and Anton Slepyshev, check out this eye hands, out of the air.
Bouliot and Andre Sekera are at the blue line. Nugent Hopkins trying to feed it out in front. Bouliot scores.
Now they're going to work down low against three very tough characters. But what did Louis DeBrus talk about? Where are the goals getting scored from? The blue paint. Tuukka Rask's night is over. Anton Khudobin comes in.
They're doing it against the number one penalty-killing team in the league. Dominic Moore scores! The ninth shorthanded goal for the Boston Bruins this season.
Oscar Klefbom provides a beautiful screen. Cam Talbot didn't see it. Here's the screen coming up. Yeah.
Sit back for McQuaid. Pass intercepted. Here comes Dreisaitl by himself with McDavid. Dreisaitl cutting for the net. Takes the shot. Scores! Cleon Dreisaitl.
I'll just do it myself and short sides it on Anton Khudobin.
Klefbom. Klefbom. Slap shot. Rebound. Nash can't get it by Klefbom. He'll give it to McDavid. Right out in front for Dreisaitl. Lucic side of the net. Scores!
Occupying the important ice again. Where's the goal getting scored from? Getting scored from right in front of the net.
Ooh, now to Krejci. Krejci to Marchand. Marchand hanging onto it. Krejci will hammer the shot home. A power play goal makes it 7-4.
Right by Falk. The trailer, Strom, right in. It tips in. Off Chimera, out in front. Jason Chimera gets the goal. The Islanders off and running.
It looks like this hits Slavin, is it?
Yeah.
Deflects. I'm not sure if it touched Chimera as well.
For Lindholm, calling for it. Pesci, a slap pass, unattainable. Back it goes. Lindholm for Slavin. They score! To a screen out in front. Jacob Slavin from well out. And Carolina has tied it. Onto the corner now for Nordstrom. This way, Stempniak. Caught off the rebound. No, it stays out. They score! They get to the rebound opportunity. It's Joakim Nordstrom at the side of the goal, and Carolina has a 2-1 lead.
Joakim Nordstrom with just his fourth goal of the season.
Steven Gianta for the point. Seidenberg off a body. Futterbuck out of the corner. He'll walk it right out in front off the paddle of board. They score! It ricochets in. It could be Steven Gianta. And we're tied.
The Islanders and Hurricanes have played two high-scoring games earlier in the year. We got another one.
Kills off the first power play sequence tonight. Jose springs Calvin DeHaan. DeHaan with a shot. He scores! Calvin DeHaan sneaks it by Cam Ward. And the Islanders have a 3-2 lead.
This puck should never go in the NHL.
In terms of length, 9 straight away. Falk right in with a shot. He scores! Justin Falk with a bullet. Top shelf on JF Berube. More scoring, tied again.
And Falk, we talked about his shot earlier, now has a 4-game point streak, his 13th of the year. He blows this over the glove of Berube.
Tennyson turned along, brought in by Skinner. Skinner right in, he scores! Jeff Skinner leaks it through JF Berube. 4-3, Carolina.
Berube doesn't get the job done in his start, and now they'll hope Greiss can shut the door and the Islanders can try and find the equalizer.
Now Justin Falk just scored his 13th of the season with a shot. He scores! Welcome to the game, Thomas Greiss. Second goal tonight for Justin Falk. Carolina up by two.
Oh boy, that turned in a hurry, didn't it?
Sebastian Aho, who has been killing penalties of late. Right on him, and it comes back out to center. Slavin will bust in. Shorthanded. He scores! Jacob Slavin with a shorthanded goal, and Carolina leads it by three.
Four goals for the Hurricanes from their blue line. Justin Falk's got two as well.
He'll scale it in. 6:15 left in the second period. Cam Ward. Hand off to Derek Ryan. A turnover. They tip it in. Josh Hosang gets the goal, set up by Anthony Beauvillier. And the Islanders are within two.
They gave up two more quick ones. It just seems to be a dozy game for them.
Here's Skinner right in for a chance. Greiss will pat it down. And a penalty is called. And a penalty shot will be called. Jeff Skinner will take it.
Likes to get in close with the deke.
There it is. He scores. Jeff Skinner outweights Thomas Greiss.
This one is silky. It's smooth. And Carolina's got a 7-4 lead.
Cable Terrifying. Jacob Slavin moving up with a heavy shot. He scores. Jacob Slavin continues. An amazing night. Carolina with an 8-4 lead.
Tyler Graevac playing in his fourth game in four nights. Two of them in Iowa, two of them here with the Minnesota Wild. He wanted to move him to the wing to perhaps relieve some pressure. And here the Jets score, and it's Patrick Laine left alone out front. He buries a one-timer past Kemper. And just over a minute in, Winnipeg's in front 1-0. This year started in Arizona before the trade that brought him to Minnesota. It was his sixth multi-point game of his career. Granlund's in alone for Minnesota. Granlund scores! He won last night's game on a lone breakaway in overtime. And here it's goal number 21 to tie it for the Wild. Now Bufflin with it. Up the boards, but Brodin's able to hold for Minnesota. A centering pass. Granlund trying to sneak one across. Graevac scores! What a play by Granlund to set it up. And Graevac puts Minnesota in front.
Great second effort by Mikael Granlund, who, after he makes this play, gets Graevac, scores the goal.
To carry it back through neutral. Off the boards to Granlund. Granlund around Scheifele. Granlund looking, waiting to Holla. Center scores! The pass was in his skates, but Holla deflects it in off of Hellebuck. And Minnesota, with a power play goal, extends the lead.
Granlund is able to just drop a little pass over, and Holla banks it off of Hellebuck.
Armia there for Winnipeg, but he's tied up by Hansel. Out to the point, Scandella winds and fires, scores!
Just a snapper, and boy, the timing was perfect. He put the hit on Niederreiter. Niederreiter responded, and so he responded back again.
Lowry works his way toward the goal. They score! It somehow sneaks by Kemper, and Winnipeg cuts the lead to 4-2.
Well, this was just a little flip shot towards the front of the net, and Kemper had it, but then it appeared to bounce away from him.
Had it deflected by Scandella, retrieved by Brodin. He plays it out to center. Stewart had it hop over his stick. Manages to recover to White. He scores! Stewart and White combine again, and Minnesota back in front by three.
White, who uses the defender as a screen and rifles one home, and we're going to have a goalie change.
Grabs the loose puck. Plays to the line for Morrissey. Across to Bufflin. Off the end boards. Wheeler with a chance. Then on the wraparound, it's loose. They score. Perreault left alone in the high slot. Beats Kemper on a long rebound, and it's 5-3.
By the time the shot came, he wasn't out at the top of his crease.
Got it. Carries to center. Armia over the Minnesota line. His shot goes wide. Rebound. They score. It came off the end glass and looked like it caught Kemper and deflects into the Minnesota goal. The seventh shorthanded goal for Winnipeg this season.
This puck had eyes for the Winnipeg Jets. Just an unfortunate carom there.
each of which included an empty net goal for the Wild. Always seems to be tight when these two teams play. Perreault back to Scheifele. He scores, and it's 5-5.
Line rush. Line A drives the middle, pulls the defender with them, and Scheifele is just there as trailing, just puts it home here over the glove of Kemper. And as Dubnyk comes out to go into the nets for Kemper.
10 seconds left to the man advantage. Scandella intercepts, plays it ahead for Halla. Halla racing after it, shorthanded for Minnesota. He has Zucker with him. Zucker scores!
What a great heads-up play there by Halla. Zucker was all alone trailing the play. Sweeps it into the net past Hutchinson and gives the Wild the lead yet again.